Hello everyone, Professor Rako here. This is our second video in the earnings per share chapter. We're focusing in now on all of our dilutive securities, meaning they have a dilutive effect on earnings per share, which just to take it a step further just means they result in the issuing of more shares of stock, which would dilute earnings per share. All right, so we covered convertible bonds in our last video. This video is on convertible preferred stock. So once again, I believe your Spiceland book covers this with the equity chapter when it talks about preferred stock. Kiso all puts all the dilutive securities together in one chapter. All right, so preferred stock just includes an option to convert it into a fixed number of shares of common stock. Okay, so kind of things that we need to remember here. It's considered part of equity unless there's a mandatory redemption exists. Okay, we talked about that a little bit in the equity chapter. All right, so how we account for this, we use the book value method, which debits preferred stock and additional paid in capital preferred stock. All right, so notice those are both credit balance. So a debit means we're taking them off the books and credits common stock. So that makes sense, right? When I issue preferred stock, I'm going to credit preferred stock and additional paid in capital preferred stock. So a debit to that would remove it. But if they're converting it, that means they're turning the preferred stock in. So those accounts need to go to zero. The credit to common stock puts the stock on at par. Remember, we always put stock on at par. And if there's a difference, it'll either be a debit to retained earnings or a credit to additional paid in capital common stock. All right, so let's look at an example here. We've got a company, they issued 1,000 shares of $10 par value common stock upon conversion of 1,000 shares of $5 par value preferred stock that was originally issued for a $500 premium, okay? So we got plenty of time and room here. So let's just write out the original entry, okay? So the original entry, remember, they were issuing preferred stock, so they would issue it for cash. They would credit preferred stock, and it tells us in the problem that it was issued at a premium, okay? So it was a $500 premium, so that's $500. 1,000 shares times 5, so that's $5,000 is the total par value, which means they issued the preferred stock for $5,500. Okay, so that's the original entry. That's not our answer, okay, but that's just the original entry kind of helps illustrate things. All right, so the conversion, so this was what we're going to do right here for the conversion. All right, notice it says to debit preferred stock and additional paid in capital preferred stock. All right, so we're going to debit those amounts for $5,000 and $500. Okay, so you can see we had the credits here and the debits here. So those accounts are now zero, but that's what we want because they have turned those into us. And we are going to turn around and hand them common stock. Now, typically, since we might have a debit or a credit, I skip a space here, put my common stock on. Remember, we've always put it on at par value. There's 1,000 shares, $10 par, so $10,000. All right, so clearly we need a debit of $4,500, and that would be our debit to retained earnings. Okay, so not much here, nothing too difficult when dealing with convertible preferred stock. All right, so we just want to make sure that we get the preferred stock and any additional paid in capital for that preferred stock off the books. We get the common stock issued at par value, and then we clean it up with a debit or credit to retained earnings or the additional paid in capital for the common stock account. Okay, so that will be our last little step to clean things up. All right, so that's convertible preferred stock. So we'll move on to, I believe, stock warrants is next, and then we'll do stock options, restricted stock, before getting on into earnings per share, right? So hopefully you enjoyed that quick little video here on preferred stock. Make sure you tune in next time as we continue through all these dilutive securities. All right, thanks. We'll see you next time.